typical noise that you get on the end of the record. It's got that sort of signature, sort of that's going through the it's going through the Sony SDDS on the non-sync. On the non-sync mode in Pro Logic. I'll mute that. That's kind of relaxing almost, but lift the turn on up, move it over. There we go. That's it then. Stop. Grab another LP. I've listened to this one a few times now. Star Trek the Motion Picture. Focus. So I'll grab another LP. Maybe Aliens. Symphony Orchestra. An LP. Aliens. Was it In Space? No One Can Hear You. I don't know. Crackle and Pop. Oh, that's Alien, isn't it? Well, this time it's LP. I'll just put that down for a sec. Movie soundtracks are not being played in years. You know, I don't know why I kept them, but you know, I've not played them in over 30 years, and they were surprisingly in clean condition still, because they've been kept in their sleeves. And Aliens is in one of those clear ones. Oh, this is okay. I'll just give it a little clean on the cloth, you know, with a cloth. So does Hillary Clinton listen to her LPs and then clean her LPs with a cloth? Which is side one? Oh yeah, that's side one. Okay, up on there. Acid for LP. Now, of course, I get the little crackles on snap, crackle, and pops above the, because they're slightly higher frequency tones, those crackles. Doesn't bother me. I kind of like it. Yeah, I find it refreshing. I'm not sure what the actual frequency response on an LP can go down to. So far I've noticed about 30 Hz. Not bad, I like it. Of course the adjusting of the tone arm with the, let's see at the back, the counterbalance weight. So that's got to be just a little bit adjusted. Just a little bit adjusted so the stylus cartridge is a comfortable balance level sort of thing. And no, I'm not a goddamn audiophile. From what I understand, and yeah, makes sense. I like the blue light. It's a little bit Psion there. It's a little bit Psion there. Let me adjust the setting on the camera. Where is it? Something like that. It should look something like that. Otherwise, it had all that horrible cyan, which you usually get typical in these rubbish Blu-ray movies, 4K movies, because they're boosting the color levels too high, and then all the proper colors on film end up turning into a third color, a third party color, which shouldn't even be there in the first place, because it wouldn't be there optically on film if when projected. Been there, done projection. I'm not actually sure if that is an actual blue light or if it's just a blue filter with a white light in the middle, which is probably explain why it was kind of like looking, because I've noticed with some video cameras or such, when they're looking at certain lights, particularly if it's a pure sort of blue colour sort of thing with a that's just a blue, you know, like LED, it should register blue on the camera. The camera being, say, a digital camera or DSLR, because they are video devices technically. An SLR camera would be pure 35mm, and yeah, I'm guessing the right light level in the room and the camera shutter and the ISO setting, you should take a picture, you should see what you see with your eye. And what I was noticing with the camera, and that is one of my pet hates. There are a lot of rubbish 4K movies out there. 4K, you know, that goddamn rubbish format where you can see, oh, this colour, and it's like, how come no one bitches and moans and complains about it, for God's sake? You need more people bitching and moaning about it, because the film studios are doing it on purpose. And it really, as an ex-projectionist, it really rubs me the fucking wrong way, it does. Oh yeah, going after Newt, yeah. Wow. I don't know which sounds better. playing the PAL Laserdisc, which is a blast on analog audio with Dolby Stereo theatrical mix. And turn the ISO up a bit. It's already up. Turn it up a little bit. It's amazing. Now, you know, it's turntable Technics going through the Sony SDBS. Frequency response there is going on through the Lucasfilm Limited THX sound system and then through to the computer where it's multicolor using the multicolor there. Pink, well, there's a very bit of white right at the very top, but it's very faint. That's very extreme, high level, and very rare. Usually pink. You know, you see quite a bit of that if you can see it on one of those rubbish 4K movies, yeah, discs, yeah. Like War of the Rubbish Worlds, yeah, that rubbish Atmos. Yeah, and when that Manny guy gets zapped by the aliens, he hardly turns the bloody pink now, does he? Yeah, you go to the bloody DVD and the aliens zap him and he turns the flipping pink. That's flipping high dynamic range slam. And of course I've adjusted the setting to be mild or very high level on this. You know, the only thing you can't do is action replay on the turntable. With, you've got to get up and manually do it. Sensitive there. Yeah, so I've got to adjust the tone arm, the pressure on the weight, so it's at the right weight, because it seems like it's just kind of like touching but floating a little bit, where, you know, just, you know, so it needs to be a little bit more adjusting, so the pressure of it is at about the right, you know. Otherwise, when I set it up earlier and played it, you know, and even jumped around on the concrete floor, I didn't notice any vibration. So I've got to readjust that, just so it's at the right tension, right pressure.